Hi there, this is Kazungu Duncan from Aero Productions. Today I'm going to show you how to burn and dodge in Photoshop using two adjustment layers. And of course, this is an image that I used in my previous tutorial. If you did not watch this tutorial, I did it some time back. You can find a link in the description and watch on how to conduct frequency separation action. And I realized in most cases, when we do frequency separation action, we achieve images which are flat. So like, for example, this image is flat and, you know, you just want to make it look beautiful. You just want to make it, you know, look awesome and all that. So how can you do this in Photoshop with just two layers? And I'm not kidding, only two layers. So without further ado, guys, let's get started. So I said we are going to use two layers, and maybe a brief on what I mean burning and dodging is in Photoshop. So burning is making the or enhancing. So burning is enhancing the shadows, while dodging is enhancing the highlights. So that is the basic explanation that I can use for you to understand. So you enhance shadows, that one you are burning. You enhance the highlights, that you are dodging. Now let me get into this tutorial. Let me just delete this. I don't think I need it. So this is our image that we're going to work on. We are just going to, you know, just enhance the highlights and the shadows. So the two adjustment layers are just but the curves. In fact, it's only one, only that I'm going to use two of them, one for dodging and another one for burning. So let's go ahead and create an adjustment layer, the curves adjustment layer. And first I want to burn it. So I will bring down the lights just from the midtones. Just make a point and drag it down just to darken this image, not too much. Let me do something like that. We can always, you know, adjust this. By the way, some people use the 50% gray, and I'm not against it, but I found more, you know, control when you're using curves and it is non-destructive, because I can come back here later on and edit in if I needed much of it or less of it. I can really edit this in the future. So let me rename this to burning, just to keep things, you know, organized. Just call it burning, and I will turn this off. Then I will now create another curves adjustment layer, and this time around I'm going to dodge. So I'm going to rise, I mean to just lift this a bit, the so that I achieve the bright, you know, colors. And do not overdo it, don't, you know, go overboard. You can really edit this some other time. Then I will just call this dodging, just like that. And then what I'm going to do, if you've been watching my tutorials, of course we are going to invert the masks. So of course, let me turn on the burning and then select the mask. Make sure it is selected, then hit Control or Command I on your keyboard. That will create a negative mask. Then we are going to, you know, paint whenever we want to paint. Then for you to, if you don't know where to paint, you know, you don't know where the highlights are, where the shadows are, what you can do, you can create an adjustment layer, a black and white adjustment layer, so that you can, you know, see the highlights and the shadows. So allow me to create a black and white adjustment layer, and then I will kill the reds so that at least I have a dark image. So maybe to something like that, so that I can really see where I'm going to burn and where I'm going to dodge. Then we are going to take a brush, the normal brush. Hit B on your keyboard to take the brush and make sure that it's a round soft brush. A hardness to zero is when the size, you can, you know, change it whenever you want. Then in this tutorial, just do an opacity of around 10 and a flow of around 20. That one is enough, don't overdo it. Then select the mask, and you know, these dark parts are the one we are going to burn. You see, we have dark parts here and there. So these are the ones that we are going to burn. And this one, we are just imitating those, you know, artists or those people who apply, you know, makeup when ladies go to shops and makeup shops and, you know, they are being applied, you know, this makeup. We are just imitating the same thing, only that now we are using a software. So guys, let me just do that really quick. You just paint in these dark places on the face so that, you know, you can enhance those dark parts just like that. Sorry for that. Let me take it back. It's just like that. Then this one also needs to be, you know, enhanced just like that. Also on this nose, at least it should be conspicuous. The dark parts should be conspicuous just like that. Let me turn on and off to see if I'm doing something. Yes, that is before and that is after. So I'm really doing a good job just like that, the dark parts. And if you're visiting this YouTube for the first time and you like my general content on this YouTube channel, I would like you to hit that subscribe button, and not only subscribe but ring that bell so that you, my friend, do not miss any future tips, tricks or tutorials. And by the way, you can support me via Patreon so that you can make Aero Productions free for everybody forever. Find a link in the description and support me, support this course so that Aero Productions can be free for everybody. And by the way, if you also want your friends to learn this, you can like and share this video so that they can, you know, access this free tutorial and, you know, they can know how to do burning and dodging. And I said, when I started this in my intro, I said that most of us, when we do frequency separation, we achieve images that are flat, and therefore we need not to have images that look like dolls, you know. Just make sure that you burn and dodge here and there so that you can make your image to be at least, you know, natural. We need it to be as natural as possible. Allow me to turn off the black and white and just turn on and off. That is before and that is after. Look at that. I think I like it. Let me zoom out and see. That is before. That is after. It is really, really natural. So let me also do this part of the neck. I think I overlooked that. And you can see it's really giving us a good image. That it is natural. It is natural, and you can really, you know, just like it. And we are not through yet, but I really still like it at the moment, you know. It's just beautiful. By the way, I do skin retouching for ladies or even for men. It's not only ladies, at affordable prices. In case you want such, you know, services, kindly comment in the comments below so that I usually read all my comments. So whenever you comment, I'll find it and, you know, I'll really be happy to work with you. I also make mugs. I also make t-shirts, brochures, banners, business cards, anything to do with graphics, you know, I do make it, wedding cards and many, many stuff. So allow me to turn off this and just look at the before and the after. Let me position it well and turn on and off. So that is before and that is after. I won't do the hand, you know. I just need to concentrate on the face so that this tutorial can also be short. I don't want to keep you here. So that is beautiful. Let me enhance more, even up to these eyebrows, so that, you know, it's a bit natural, just like that. Give it a touch here and there, you know, just to have a beautiful image. On these cheeks, some cheeks, you know, of course it's a bone, so you expect it to be a bit dark. And this part of the forehead also to be a bit dark. Let me see the before and after. Before and after. That is beautiful. It's time now to do the dodging. we are through with burning. So let me turn on the, you know, this dodging. Select the mask and hit Control or Command I to invert that mask. Turn on this black and white so that you can see really well where your highlights are. And this time also we are just going to paint where the highlights are. So like, for example, here, just to enhance this. Remember to keep the flow and the opacity the same so that it is even. You don't want some highlights to shout and some shadows to be killed that much. So just make sure that it is fine. Let me see. Before, after, yes, it's doing a good job. Also, on this part, I want also to make sure that it is as bright as possible. Just like that. Also, this part of the forehead, you can see it needs some brightness. Just a few strokes. And by the way, I'm just using a normal mouse. So don't say you need a tablet or you need a gaming mouse. Just need a normal mouse. And things are pretty good. So if you get a tablet, that one, it becomes more easy. You can control the pen pressure, and you know, that one will really help you to, if you want to paint a lot, you know, you just control it by pressure, and that one is a beautiful thing. Also on these lips, the lips need to be also a bit bright, just like that. On this part, I don't know how this part is called. I don't know, maybe you should teach me. Let me know how this part is called in the comment below. Just comment and let me know how this one is called. So let me turn off this black and white and see what the hell I'm doing. So let me turn off and on. That is before, that is after. And I can really, really see we are doing a good thing. Let me just, you know, enhance more. Just like that. I think I like what I'm doing. And by the way, find this tutorial that I did with this picture so that you can really understand how to perform frequency separation action. And after that, you will now come and watch this tutorial. But again, you can still watch it so that you can just have a knowledge on how to perform this. So let me control zero to get the full size and see the before and after. So let me just do the overall before and after. So that is before and that is after. You can see it's a pretty good job, and I like what this has just done. You can now do away with this. Don't need it anymore. So you can do, no, I said you do away with it. Just like that. Let me see the overall before and after. That is before and that is after. You can also apply to different images. Like, for example, if I need to apply on this image, I just create a curves adjustment layer, and after creating it, I bring down this just like that, just to get the highlights. And you know, this is for burning, so if I need to burn, I'll do that, and I'll create an adjustment layer for black and white. Then I'll kill the reds so that I can really achieve a good thing. Not that much, that one is not fine. Let me just do something like that so that, you know, it just controls me. Select the mask for the curves and then hit Control I. I'll go a bit faster because you now understand what to do. Then I'll take my brush and increase the size of the brush and just, you know, paint where I can see the dark parts. Let me change this a bit so that, I think it was overdoing because of the curves, but this is fine, thank you. So let's select here and start burning, just like that. These dark parts, you know, to be darker. Also this side, reduce the size of the brush and do some bit of burning here and there. Also on this forehead, this part needs to be burned. Let me see if I'm doing something. yes, there's something being done, and I like that. Also, do this part, this part of the neck. I said I'm going to do it faster because you now understand what to do, and at least you get light on this. So, before and after, it's not that much, but at least we have enhanced these parts that are, you know, should be enhanced. And I like the I like this smile, honestly. So do like that, also this part and this part. I think they should be a bit enlightened, this part of the neck. Let me see the before and after. Before and after. Then you can also do the dodging. Just create a curves adjustment layer and take this up so that you have the brighter parts. Don't overdo it. Just like that, select the mask, control I, then you can turn on the black and white so that you know where you're painting. Then I'll increase the size of the brush and just paint. But when the brush is big, you achieve a softer edge. You know, once you increase the size, the hardness truly increases, or the feathering truly increases, and you can achieve a beautiful, beautiful, you know, shape out of it. Just paint here and there, make the brighter parts to be bright, and this part also make it bright. Just enhance it. It's already bright, but we just need to enhance it. That's before, that's after. I think it's doing a pretty good job. Also, this part should be enhanced, and this part should also be enhanced, and a little bit of a touch here and there, so that this image can be even more natural. So let me turn that off. You see, before and after, it's just a touch, it's nothing more, because the image already, I did a frequency separation and I like it. This part also should be a bit bright, also this part and many other parts. So this will take you a few minutes. I think it's tedious, it's time consuming, but then of course you need to have a beautiful, you know, image, so you don't need to say it's tedious and all that. So let me see the before and after. Before and after. Let me see the overall before and after. That is before and that is after. So guys, this is basically how to burn and dodge in Photoshop. And if you're visiting this YouTube channel for the first time, I would like you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and not only subscribe, turn on the notification so that you, my friend, do not miss any tips, tricks or tutorials that I offer every week. And if you like this video, I would like you to share it to your friends and family so that they can also learn about this. Give me likes on this video so that, you know, I can also find that, you know, morale to make more videos and help me achieve my dream. And guys, I just want to say thank you so much for remaining supportive to my YouTube channel. I've really seen it grow from step to step, and I really anticipate it to grow even more. So I'm very, very thankful for your support as individuals, your support as community, and I really trust that we are going somewhere. Make me, you know, known to your people, to your friends, so that, you know, this channel can become viral. I really give in-depth tutorials to do with Photoshop, so it's something that you can share with your friends. And I just take this time to market myself and tell you that I'm really, really into this business of offering tutorials that are free about Photoshop. So guys, I really hope that you're going to subscribe. I really hope that you're going to like. I really hope that you're going to share this video. And I just want to say that may God bless you and may God keep you. And as we really go through these hard times, I want just to encourage you and tell you that it is not yet over. Let us not give up. Let us press on. And I know that this coronavirus is going to end. Otherwise, guys, let's meet in the future tutorials. Until then, remember to keep creating.